Welcome, Broodlings, to a brand new Let's Play. This is the RPG Chick. In honor of the 50th anniversary of Star Trek, believe it or not, I'm playing Star Trek 25th anniversary. And, well, a few notes on this really quick. This is the fully voiced CD-ROM version. This was released in 1992. And this can be seen to represent the fourth year of the five-year mission being... Star Trek was canceled after the third year, or during the third year, I don't know how that works, but I'm saying, oh, way too much. I also played in the past Star Trek Borg and Star Trek Klingon. I'll put links in case you guys want to see that. I am going to be playing Star Trek Judgment Rites, which is the sequel to this game, as well as Star Trek The Next Generation Final Unity. These are all on PC, by the way, and except for the last one, Star Trek Futures Past, which is on the Genesis. Now, what's interesting about this game is it was released on Nintendo as well, but of course with not fully voiced, and on the Amiga, and I don't think it was fully voiced there either. So this is, it's a cool deal. All the original cast. And I'd like to say hello to Jeroen, or Jeroen, if I'm saying that right. He wanted me to play specifically Final Unity, but I am going to be getting to that. So, Jeroen, I know you've been waiting years, literally, but just getting to it now, and it's just, I realized it's the 50th anniversary. As I look at this, I'm like, okay, that's the 25th anniversary. How many years now? 50, and then I found out they have events coming up and all kinds of stuff, but intro.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise.
They sure are.
Its mission? To explore strange new worlds, to discover new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
I find this theme going on right here to be simultaneously, like, adorable and hilarious. So I guess this is the MIDI version of the Star Trek theme. Now, I've been a fan of Star Trek for many years, since I was a little kid. I do prefer Next Generation.
Demon World.
Although that's kind of blasphemous me to say,
well,
isn't
it? The Enterprise's primary mission is peaceful exploration. The galaxy holds many surprises. To be prepared, we are conducting a mock battle with the USS Republic.
Oh, yeah.
Captain Patterson reports the Republic is in position and ready to begin, Captain.
The Republic is arming weapons and raising shields. I suggest we do the same, Captain.
Keyboard shortcuts.
Raising shields.
S for shields.
Arming weapons.
W for weapons. And you can see above his head where the dot. Above Kirk's head, where the ship is. I'm probably going to lose this battle. Although I'm starting off pretty well, I think.
Hi, sir.
Is that what I want to be doing? Wait, he's up here. Trying to anticipate. I could use something popping up. I want to improve the view screen.
Hi, sir.
I'm a noob at this. I don't know what these represent.
Hi, sir.
Wes, where are we over here? Gonna die. Well, I'm gonna simulate a die. He's all the way up. He's over here.
Patterson extends his congratulations.
Oh, I skipped past that, too.
Lowering shields and disarming weapons.
Message coming in from Starfleet.
Yay!
On screen, Lieutenant.
I won?
The Enterprise is ordered to travel to Pollux 5. The natives report that alien life forms have been attacking the settlers near a mine at Mount Idol. You are to report to the High Prelate of the colony.
Oh, I don't know how to advance that. Now, right, there's keyboard shortcuts. First of all, I can't stop us bouncing all over the place. Look around the ship a little. These are... You can use the mouse, or you can use keyboard shortcuts for some things, anyway.
Captain's log.
No recent missions have been accomplished, or completed, in both. This is to beam down.
We're not in orbit, Captain.
Captain's losing his mind. And this is your save, load, music, no music, sound effects, no sound effects.
Save new game.
LP1. Now you can switch back and forth. This is your view screen. If you hit V, you get to see everything. Good for fighting if you know where the ships are. If you don't, well, you need that radar between Sulu and Chekhov and above Kirk to show you the dots there. You also can also get an analysis of the ship, of the enemy ship, which I did not do. That's a planet. I don't even think we can do anything with that. This is Sulu, of course.
May I respectfully remind the captain that we haven't accomplished our mission, sir.
I'm not even sure what that represents.
Raising shields.
And that's shields, of course. You can also use S.
Lowering shields, Captain.
To toggle. Chekhov. This is our speed, I believe. Oh no, this is a navigational map. Okay, good. How do I get out of this? Oh, I'm going to... I don't mean to head there. We're gonna die now.
We're off course, Captain.
Instruments indicate that we have crossed the Klingon neutral zone. Klingon ship is arming its weapon systems and raising shields.
Damage control standing by, sir.
Message from the Klingon commander, sir.
On screen.
Enterprise, you are in violation of Klingon space. Your ship is forfeit. Prepare to die.
Shields up.
Raising shields.
Weapons.
Arming weapons.
View. They're over here somewhere. Wait, 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 wait. Now where are they? They're down here. Analysis, I think? Okay, so now we can see the status of their ship. We might just defeat these guys, possibly. Get over here. They must be taking evasive maneuvers. Look how they're just, like... Nice! Okay, so that's what happens when you go somewhere other than what you're supposed to go. Even if you go to a system, I believe, that you can go to later on. So now I know what the map is. So you hit tab to go from one to the other. That's the map. What's this?
Disarming weapons.
Alright, good idea.
Lowering shields, Captain.
Okay, so, and then Kirk, and then we've got Scotty here. This is his, all his, you know, things he can repair. Or you can also hit D to get into this. Isn't it? Yeah, D for damage control.
Aye, sir. I don't know how long she can take it, Captain. Shields repaired, Captain.
Okay. Spock?
I advise referring to the star map and setting a course for the Pollux system, sir.
So you can confer with Spock. You can ask a computer about things. Like Kirk.
Kirk. James. Full name. Captain James Tiberius Kirk. Current captain of the USS Enterprise. The youngest captain in the history of Starfleet. Captain Kirk has been decorated many times and is considered one of Starfleet's best officers and a superb military commander.
Why, thank you, computer. I can't type.
Spock. Full name. Uncodable in English language. First officer of the USS Enterprise. Spock is one of the finest science officers in Starfleet, and has been awarded numerous Starfleet and Federation decorations.
Uhura?
Uhura. Full name, Lieutenant Nyota Uhura. Lieutenant Uhura is the Chief Communications Officer of the USS Enterprise. Uhura is fourth in command of the Enterprise. And is considered an expert computer analyst, specializing in communications equipment and linguistics.
And linguistics. Got to type that. Will Scotty work?
Topic not available, Captain.
Doesn't recognize him as Scotty. Scott.
Scott. Montgomery. Full name. Lieutenant Commander Montgomery Scott. Chief Engineer of the USS Enterprise. Montgomery Scott is one of the most respected engineers in Starfleet and has published numerous papers on starship engineering. Scott is considered the foremost expert on the engine systems of the Constitution class starship.
I don't know how I advance ahead with that.
Scott. Montgomery.
Oh, I see.
Name. Lieutenant Commander Montgomery Scott.
I didn't notice
Chief
these.
Chief Engineer of the USS Enterprise. Montgomery Scott is one of the most respected engineers in Starfleet and has published numerous papers on starship engineering. Scott is considered the foremost expert on the engine systems of the Constitution class starships.
This was the way games were back then, guys. You didn't have, like, all this friendly, you know, clicking and radial dialogue wheels and everything. This was what you got back then.
Sulu. Hikaru. Full name. Lieutenant Hikaru Sulu. Chief Helmsman of the USS Enterprise. Sulu is considered one of the most capable officers in Starfleet. Hikaru graduated near the top of his class at the Academy and is considered an excellent military tactician.
Yes, the best of the best here. I think this is how you write it.
Topic not available.
Nope. Why doesn't the computer tell me the topic isn't available?
Daystrom, Richard. Widely considered the father of modern artificial intelligence, Dr. Daystrom is a legend in the world of computing. His dualtronic circuits won him great acclaim. His multitronic experiments were less successful.
Well, that's a bug. We got to hear about Daystrom and read about Chekhov. Oh. I'm almost done, guys. See anything about the Enterprise?
USS Enterprise. Federation Constitution class starship. Currently commanded by Captain James T. Kirk. on the fourth year of a five-year mission of exploration. Its first officer is Mr. Spock. Its registration number is NCC-1701.
Right, so this is the fourth year. And if I have it right, then Judgment writes the sequel to this is the fifth year. This may or may not produce a result. Can't type or talk.
Starfleet.
There you go.
The official body of the Federation that is involved with space exploration and contact with alien worlds. Starfleet is based on human naval traditions, but military matters are not its primary mission. Starfleet Academy, the training branch of Starfleet. The Academy is located on Earth. Nearly every member race of the Federation has sent representatives to the Academy. Starfleet, the official body.
So, and who we just fought were Klingons.
Klingons, a humanoid life form that has used genetic manipulation to stratify their population. Their homeworld is Kling. Klingon's culture is based on the principle of survival of the fittest, either through guile or physical force. Principles of honor are used to prevent the culture from killing itself completely. But these principles are extended outside their species only to non-Klingons who have proved themselves in battle. Negotiations over planets in the disputed area have been slowly advancing, hindered by recent Klingon technological exchanges with the Romulans. The Klingon Empire itself is economically backward and poorly organized, but their military force is extremely formidable.
Okay. I just want to see.
Tribbles. Discovered by Cyrano Jones on a planet whose location is unknown. These charming animals have, with some alterations, become a favorite pet on many Federation planets.
Oh, what happened? I was reading that.
Tribbles. Discovered by Cyrano Jones on a planet whose location is unknown. These charming animals have, with some alterations, become a favorite pet on many Federation planets.
Oh, that quits out like that.
Topic not available, Captain.
Yeah, these were the good old days before the Borg, huh? Alright, what else? Uhura?
Orders are to proceed to the Pollux system.
And, that's about it. Okay, so let's proceed to the Pollux system. Which I believe is here. If I'm wrong, we're gonna get into another fight. Now, there's a map along with this game that I took a picture with on my cell phone. And, basically used as copy protection, I guess, back then. You needed to advance to the correct area, otherwise you're just getting battles endlessly. So I think Pollux is here. Can I quit out? Wish I knew how to quit out of this. I'm not gonna... I want to look up Pollux, but... Eh.
We have arrived at Pollux 5.
Okay, come look up Pollux now.
Pollux 5 system, an inhabited satellite of Pollux B. Pollux 5 has lately emerged from an ice age caused by large meteor strikes. It has recently been colonized by the acolytes of the star's religious sect. The planet is home to a wide variety of plant life, but insects and other lower life forms are the only known animals.
Thank you, computer. So if we go... This is orbit. You can also hit O.
Entering standard orbit.
And I'm sure there's a... keyboard command for beaming down, but I don't know what it is.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the car.
I wish the sound wouldn't skip like that.
This is so much better, gentlefolk. We are honored at your presence and hope you will find peace here in our haven.
Now I talk to and...
Captain, the flora on this planet is very interesting. I wonder how useful it may be for medicinal purposes.
Sounded a little odd at the end the way you said that. Like sinister almost. Now we've pretty much arrived at the spot which I've played up to. The rest of this is completely blind. I do know how to talk to people and stuff. You got this icon here. This is use item. This is look, talk, take, and this is your menu, same as before. You can move around like so. So I can look at this. All mining equipment use this route.
A quickly constructed Spartan shelter, primarily used by fledgling colonies.
It's too bad they couldn't get Major Barrett to do the, you know, computer voice and narrator voice. It would have been great. You can talk to people.
Captain, demons and supernatural creatures are, almost by definition, illogical. Yet it is evident these people believe what they have seen. Barring illness or mass hysteria, I agree that a real problem seems to exist.
Doctor, you need to investigate the possibility of disease, mental or physical, among these people before we go chasing up the mountains. Prelate Angiven, may we see those who have encountered the demons?
They are already gathered in the chapel and will cooperate in any way with you. First door on my right.
This planet's as beautiful as everyone says it is.
The trees, the fresh air, the freezing cold.
Come on, Bones. The cold will improve your circulation.
Some people get too much circulation.
Does cold really improve your circulation?
I don't know if the problem is real, the result of a new illness, or mass hysteria. But at the very least, there's an injured miner who needs my help.
Just want to say I miss Leonard Nimoy very much still.
I've never seen snow like this before. This is great.
You mean you've never built a snowman, Ensign?
I've never even thrown a snowball. Do you think anyone would mind?
Well...
Later, Ensign. We have work to do.
Of course, sir.
Does he want to build a snowman? Let's look at stuff.
A beautiful snow-covered scene with a path leading off to Mount Idol. A beautiful snow-covered scene with a path leading off to... Remnants of a recent snowfall cover the ground. High Prelate Angiven waits patiently for you to decide what you will do next. Spock raises an eyebrow.
Mm-hmm. He always was good at that.
James Tiberius Kirk, captain of the Enterprise. He's always happy to run an errand of mercy. Dr. Leonard McCoy, the finest doctor in Starfleet, wishes that he were on a warmer planet. Ensign Everts, who has never been this close to snow before in his life, gazes with childlike fascination at the ground.
I'll try not to get the red shirt killed, but I can't make any promises, of course. Now, here are your weapons, analyzers, and such, tricorders. If we try to kill this guy...
Jim, are you out of your mind?
Evidently. This is stun, this is kill.
Nothing to report, Captain.
That's Spock's, tricorder, possibly. He analyzes stuff.
Nothing to report, Captain.
And usually there's nothing to report, Captain.
The man's in perfect health.
So that's his medical tricorder.
Nothing to report, Captain.
You get the feeling there's nothing to report, Captain? Finally, yeah, medicine bag.
Why would you want to do that? Let's not go misusing a medical kit, Jim.
Or medical kit, rather. Right, so let's talk to him.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise. We have received word that alien life forms are creating problems at your mining facilities at Idle Mountain. Tell me more. Most High Prelate Angiven, I am honored to meet you.
Oh,
I consider it my divine duty to assist you in any possible way with the spawn of the devil.
That's a little off, isn't it?
Been seeing ghosts and boogeymen, eh? I find that a little hard to believe. I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the USS Enterprise.
Choosing us.
We have received... Certainly, Captain Kirk. Not aliens per se. We have encountered what we believe are demons at Idle Mountain. Creatures surely emerging from the very gates of hell.
Mm-hmm.
Our god would not test us thus without reason. So we believe your might and insight are our god's method to help us discover what is going on.
Aside from seeing demons, has any hard data been collected? Any evidence I could see? Demons? Gates of hell? This is the 23rd century. Aside from seeing demons, has any hard data... Demon? Aside from seeing demons, has any hard data been collected?
Yes,
any evidence?
A skeptic would consider everything merely anecdotal or unproven. My people will gladly tell you their own stories, so you need not hear it secondhand through me.
What can you tell me about the mine itself? You're wasting the time of a starship capable of destroying this planet with campfire stories? No wonder you were dumped out here in the middle of nowhere. What can you tell me about the mine itself?
The area is exceptionally stable tectonically, and easy for our machinery to work in, praise God. We've mined for hafnium and a variety of useful trace elements. The deeper we dig, however, the more anomalous the variety of minerals seems to be. Our Ignatiate brother Stephen has his own theories about why this might be. Either way, the anomalies inspired Brother Canbury to conduct studies inside the mine. Yesterday, he reported discovering a strange door. A gate to hell, sure.
Hellgate.
For the demons caused a cave-in immediately. Canbury was trapped, unconscious, and the demons prevent us from rescuing him. We can only hope he is still alive. Thank you for your courtesy, Kirk. May you receive the guidance and protection of our god as you complete this divine mission.
Why, thank you. This door.
A quickly constructed Spartan shelter.
Alright. Headed for the door then. Now you only control Kirk. Well, that's interesting. They're apparently monks and believe in demons, yet this is. They've got Star Trek doors. We heard that trademark sound. Let's look around.
Boxes of supplies and mining equipment litter the floor. A majestic view of Mount Idle can be seen through the skylight. A chapel typical of the Acolytes of the Stars. James Kirk takes time to rest and ponder the remainder of the mission. McCoy looks anxiously about the room.
Good flavor text, you know.
Spock waits for your command, patient as ever. Ensign Everts cannot take his eyes off the sight of Mount Idle.
Well, apparently he has.
A sturdy man of advanced years whose blue eyes meet yours with clarity, curiosity, and directness.
What's under wraps here?
Boxes of supplies and mining equipment... A grim-faced minor colonist nods curtly at you.
Colonist?
The Tellarite appears completely at home surrounded by humans, but the wrinkling on his brow indicates a great deal of worry.
I recognize the name Tellarite.
You'll understand if I don't stand up, I hope. I am not well.
I am worried about Brother Chubb. Can you examine him, Doctor?
He is too busy consoling the wounded man.
And this guy? Look at that, he's got, like, hooves. This is your demon right here.
He is too busy consoling the wounded man.
Is the wounded man busy?
This man is in no condition to talk.
Well, yeah, he talked when we look at him, but when I talk to him, he doesn't say anything. We're gonna help this man. Analyze him, McCoy.
Jim, this man has suffered severe physical injuries to his head and arm. The wounds have been adequately cared for. However, he has developed a Nugarian infection. If not treated swiftly, the effects can be fatal. The infection can normally be treated with hypodidoxin, but there's none on the Enterprise.
I may be of some assistance. The Lorexian berry grows near the mouth of the cave. If I could acquire it, I would be able to synthesize the hypodidoxin from the berry. Unfortunately, the demons prevent us from approaching the cave entrance. Perhaps you could retrieve it for me.
Perhaps. I don't suppose this would be of any help.
This man is getting worse. We've got to find those berries before he dies.
And on that note, I'm going to call this an episode. I know we didn't get far. Barely started this mission. So tune in next time when we actually accomplish things. Endure. In enduring, grow strong. Live long and prosper.